Tigres jumping onto the field. Victor Cáceres, the match official, leading them right onto the field. And the fans, of course, with hopes to see Monterrey. Diego on the defensive line. Now, Victor Rodriguez on the perfect position with Sosa.
Sosa up top, the back line of Hernandez, Venegas, Manzanares. Love that name. Vasquez and Mendoza.
Open door.
Tina has the throw.
Tina now with Mosquera from the right side. Bison right in the middle. Paul Jordi picking it up. Wait from one and two defenders still inside the area. Moving around, to the ground. No fouls in the match. Baseball was very close.
Nivers came in Wednesday night as a substitute.
Cross and the header from Jordi over the target. But okay. Forward a long ball. So Venegas getting in the way of the pass. Jordi now on the right side. Looking to cross the ball in. There's four players from the right. The shots are coming from the middle. Just wide. And we have a goal.
More good ball movement.
Good on the back heel. Now it is up by the blade in the back. Deflected away by the defenders. The attack in the corner. Good touch. Back to Canales. And now going out wide on the right side for Maximiliano Mesa. Medina, they cross it out of the way by the defense who's there on that side. It is Arteaga picking up the rebound. Jorge Rodriguez gets close. Rodriguez into the area. Diving header just in front of the goal, but over the target.
Outstanding ball movement by Monterrey and
right back.
So he's so good at dancing out of trouble with the ball at his feet, able to deliver it to Meza.
Rodriguez. And Monterrey, they do this a lot. Back middle, go to the right. They are able to penetrate the defense.
Folks, I know sometimes it's difficult when you're watching a game on TV to watch away from the ball, but look for Cortizo. Watch him off the ball.
Jordi, the cross out of the way. John Medina picking up the rebound. The shots just wide of the goal, defended by Anderson. It's a goal.
While Canales is on the ball.
Canales, a pretty good pass going towards Arteaga. The cross, and that one appeared to be a handball inside the area. Yes, sir. Match official points over to the penalty spot, and it's a penalty awarded to Monterrey in the 26th minute. Handball inside the area. Monterrey to take the lead here in the 29th minute. Waiting for the green light from Cáceres. He's Sergio Canales taking a few steps. He shoots in the goalkeeper with a stop and a goal. Right off the rebound. Bertrame. Bertrame coming in, picking up the rebound, sending that one into the back of the net. And it is 1-0 in the 29th minute.
Really, the only guys we have mentioned are the five defenders for Querétaro.
This is a pretty promising play for Monterrey. Jordi! Excellent effort here from Jordi. Moving around, getting the space, sticks his shots.
Corner, and we got Canales, and Canales will end up taking this one.
There goes the corner. Towards Mesa, who hits it back inside the area. But the defense are trying to clear the ball away. Mesa. Keep it for Monterrey. Look at this one. Opportunity for Querétaro. This is Sosa. He's got the 1-1. Sosa has got the 1-1. No! What a save in the back by Entrada. Correct says. They just wake up. They wake up late. And it always happens.
It's like Querétaro kept on hitting the snooze button.
Another late for work.
It's still late for work, right? Well, they've only, they've had the ball 20% of the time.
And that 20% they pretty much have spent on this side, although the last few minutes is the only push forward that we've seen from them. As in this particular play with Lindora trying to control a long pass. Arturo once again with a header back to Rodriguez, and it's Ivan Rodriguez. He's able to pull the trigger and into the hands of Andrada. This should do it for the first half, though.
So they take two shots, and both of them are on target. And what's interesting is Monterrey doesn't get a goal in a run of play. It takes a handball in the box for them to get on the box on the board. We go to the break. So we'll keep an eye on if, in fact, the formation changes at all for Querétaro. We are underway as Victor Caceres, the man with the Barbasol and the whistle, has gotten us started here in the second half, along with Jose Cerna. I'm Bruce Silverman. Thank you so much for spending your Saturday night with us. Hernandez pushing it out to the left, getting it back. And then they'll go across the stripe all the way back to Allison. Allison punched away a set piece. Penalty kick only for Bertarame to put it in the back of the net in the 29th minute. And if you're just joining us, that is all the scoring we had for you in the first half. And Sosa off the bar, and that is just the way the night has gone.
The start of the second half, and we've seen a lot of action, but definitely what we need to see from Querétaro is that this particular phase, offense, go for it, take the shot. Sosa now having a second glove.
Right now, moving forward into the middle. Canales outside to Jordy. Jordy into the middle. That is a big-time save. That ball was rising. Might have been on target.
Is replacing Hernandez with the number 189. Also, Sosa leaves out the field. He suffered a big injury too long ago. Definitely his level has decreased. Jordy's out. The ball. Now that he's out, it should fall. Sergio Canales.
And here is Medina beating the defender, picking up the loose ball, centering. Back of the net, just came in. Rojas makes it 2-0 in the 66th minute. The lights are out. The party is on. Monterrey.
Excellent ball movement, and this is exactly what they are known for in Monterrey. They can hit you from anywhere. And it was a great effort also by Johan Rojas. Just minutes after coming off the bench, he thanks the Lord for having this opportunity. He finds at the back of the net. And what it was, a sensational cross coming in from the right side, past a few players, and even in front of the goal. There's the 21-year-old Colombian player getting his first goal of the Apertura. Excellent touch. As you can see, Alisson complaining to his defenders. Just look at the way that this ball is swung in from Colombian to Colombian. Medina to
Dos, uno. Babel.
The babel works. There he is, Rojas.
Babel should be sponsoring me by this point. Or at least, you know, Rosetta Stone should jump in, try to steal the business away. Guzman.
Who's those?
Guzman flicking it towards the corner. Here's a delivery into the middle. Canales, mouth of the 18! Back!
Oh! Just wide.
How? Optical illusion. Great delivery here.
Once again, it's Joe Medina working that right side of the field. He's the one sending the dangerous passes in. And look at this one. Actually, it was a little bit wide.
Thrown off by the BBVA side.
Another good chance over here for Sergio Canales, who should have actually stepped up even more after Jordy was replaced. Absolutely not. I mean, it's the offside rule, though.
Here's Vasquez. Opportunity. Cutting back. Coming back to the ball. Back of the net. He gets his goal. Vasquez in the 85th minute, but it is waved off.
Of course, if the whole body is offside, and perfect, I agree.
Okay, 100%. 100%.
Not the toenail. In this particular time, the whole body is offside. So a few plays to bring a lot of danger and get two goals.
Monterrey has done enough tonight to win this match, but that's not going to be enough. Is that finds the back of the net? Just when I'm talking about a win, it is now an interesting match. Closing out the 88th minute, Lopez makes it a 2-1 affair. Now we have two substitutes, one on each side, that have gotten goals. Lopez came in the 60th. He gets one back in the 88th. That's the broadcaster's jinx right there. You start talking about a Monterrey win, and now it's 2-1.
Fantastic goal.
He has to be frustrated by his club giving up a goal. And at the same time, he's got to be happy that his guy got the goal. It's a little bizarre if you think about it. And it's something that's so unique about football that you can loan a guy as this goes right at Allison, and then Allison punches it away. We are in the fourth minute of eight.
It's going to be tested once more with this long-range shots by Rojas. I'm looking for a double in the Knights. Pretty good reaction by Allison sending that one to the corner.
You don't see in any other sport where a team will send a player in their same league to the other team and then have to play against that player. You don't see it in any other sport. Rio. Another opportunity here. The captain. Outside. Vasquez. Denied. Allison coming up big. Vasquez wanted the brace.
Opportunities on both ends for Querétaro would have meant the one glorious point. The other side would have been a good closing.
That'll do it. That'll do it from inside BBVA Monterrey.